You can easily shape polylines and polyline-based objects using the Polyline subtraction tool. For the simplest example of this, I will use the 2D CAD drawing tools and draw two rectangle polylines and a circle in the middle of my screen, making sure that they overlap one another. To use the Polyline subtraction tool, you will select the object that you want an area subtracted from. For instance, if I want this area subtracted from this polyline, I will select this polyline first and then click on the Polyline subtraction tool in the Edit toolbar at the bottom of my screen. Then click on the object that you want removed from it. You'll then have the option to either delete the original polyline or retain it and the new edited polyline. I will delete it. This will subtract the area where those two polylines overlapped. Here I want to note that the Polyline subtraction tool will not work on circles, ovals, or ellipses drawn with the circle tools. You will note that when I select the circle, the Polyline subtraction tool does not appear in the Edit toolbar at the bottom. However, if you form a circle from a rectangle polyline using some of the Edit tools at the bottom, you can use this to subtract from another polyline or subtract from it using another polyline. You can also use the Polyline subtraction tool on polyline-based 3D objects. Here I have a custom countertop, an oddly shaped slab, and a simple polyline solid. You can use objects of the same type or use different object types. If I select the custom countertop, then click on the Polyline subtraction tool, then click on the polyline solid, it will subtract the area where the polyline solid overlapped the countertop in plan view. Now, let's use the slab and the countertop. Note two things. The slab shape separates the countertop in two separate areas, here and here. And in camera view, note that they are not on the same vertical plane. The countertop is at 36 inches in height. The slab is at 4 inches. And when I select the countertop, then the polyline subtraction tool, then the slab disappears, and the countertop is now in two separate pieces because of the way the slab overlapped it in plan view. You can also use the polyline subtraction tool on shape objects. Here, I'll go to the Primitive Tools parent tool and use the Box tool and place a box. Let's open the box dialog and change the height to 48 inches. Then, I'll use the Sphere tool and place a sphere that overlaps the box. Now I'll take a camera view. I'll select the box, then the Polyline subtraction tool, and then click on the sphere. It has subtracted the rounded shape out of the original box. So with some creativity, you can use these shapes and edit tools, like the Polyline subtraction tool, to create some interesting design features.